think I might be good, motherfuckers. Look at this. Legacy controller. This stick is bulky as hell in comparison to this. Whatever. But anyway, let's hit this shit. Shit, wait, I can't, okay, wait a minute, hang on. So do I have to, there we go, okay, cool. So if I, uh-oh, wait, shit, that's not a good look. Why did it stop working? Oh, you know what it is? I'll bet you. Now do you work? Okay, there we go. Now I'm figuring it out. Oh, God. Whoo! The bad thing is this is kind of like... Oh, wait.
Huh?
These are not... These buttons are not working the way they're supposed to be working. That is not my cancel. What's my... Why is that like that? Let me check the... Hang on. That is not correct. That is very weird. My square button is apparently my circle. Triangle's correct. R1 is apparently L1. Drive is correct. So that means, yeah, my circle and my square are swapped. And it looks like my R1 and my L1 are swapped. Yeah. So are my L2 and R2 swapped? They are. Where did I put my other... God damn, I put my other stick away. I want to just check and see. Well, I mean, that makes no sense. That's just... I mean, whatever. It's perfectly fine. Because obviously, as long as... Well, unfortunately, unless... Let me check this out. Does this work? No, it's still... So I'm just going to have to get used to navigating menus by backing out by hitting a square button instead of the circle button, which is going to be very awkward. Wait, what did that say? Shit. I was pressing circle. What did that actually say? Acrux Combo Arcade Joystick. That's kind of cool that it actually... Why doesn't it tell me what controller I'm using like that normally? I like that kind of information. It's absolutely useless, but it's still kind of cool. Don't want to start... I should start switching up my colors a little bit. Bullet Tager. Pretend I'm playing Bullet. Hulk Tager. We can't use that one. I remember that. You can't really see purple throws very well with that color. It's not a good look. Yo, there's my Hawkman color. Let's mess around with some Tager. That's gonna be very irritating. Oh shit. That's gonna be very irritating for me. Having to utilize, it's actually something that pisses me off too with, I think it's mostly Nintendo systems. A lot of them will switch around. Like, in terms, so usually when you have your four basic face controllers, the majority of designers, the bottom button is confirm, the right hand button is cancel, which is X and circle. And in a lot of Nintendo games, it's the opposite, where the rightmost button will be confirm, but the bottom button will be cancel. And so it's always irritating to try and, adjust to that. Also, like, can you listen to these buttons? They're so much more pressy. That makes no sense, but yeah. Oh, that's right. Isn't Hakumen one of the characters? He is. I need to figure out when the hell I can. Oops. When I can do that and when I can't. This is a little, like, the stick's very, it's different. I mean, you can hear how pressy the buttons are. The buttons have a very different feel to them. But also, the stick layout is a bit different. Oh, Yeah, so that definitely does not work. I don't know why I just tried to do that. Shit. I just realized I don't have my touchpad, so I can't automatically make this go back. This is another reason not to use training mode. Does that work off of the heaps? God help me. I'm actually surprised that hit. Oh, that's right. That was... Interesting. What am I doing wrong? I know that's the combo everybody uses. Do they do JC into that? Maybe they do. Oh my Christ. Wait, that one distinctly shows up there. Why did that not give me the... Huh. No, that definitely did not work. Maybe if they're magnetized. God damn it. No, not even that works. So this definitely would not work. Yep. So what am I missing? Is it because I don't have any pull beforehand? Oh my Christ. That is it. Okay. Well, that's obviously not gonna work. But yeah, okay, so that's the problem. So I cannot do that particular combo unless they are magnetized. Otherwise, I go for the basic. Let me actually just check and see. So that does 34-30. Versus... to run out of magnetism again. Oh my god. It is 34-31. So it really doesn't matter. You might get more meter off of that one. I don't know. I guess the big difference is you land that bit of magnetism in there so you don't have to worry about... Because one of the big problems with Tager now is due to the destruction of Gadget Finger, you want to find ways to not have to use Gadget Finger. And so using that particular setup, using that particular combo route, gives you magnetism mid-combo, whereas doing the other version, which I would have to do if they are not magnetized, which I'm going to need to... solidify that in my brain, doesn't give you any magnetism, so it just risks that running out. I also need to figure out when the hell you can do that and when you can't. So it looks like it basically has the same rules as when you can do that particular setup. That was supposed to be the anti-air version. I'm so slow and ponderous with my 360s now because I don't trust the game to give them to me. Okay, so maybe it's just a bad idea to use that jab on the way down. It's very different if they block it, for instance. Oh no, that's not what I wanted. God damn it. Because you can basically do it instantly if they block it. But if they get hit by it, that's another issue. Okay, not instantly. But close to it. So anyway, what else do we practice with Taker? Oh, you know what I should practice, actually? Oh, that only works if they're not magnetized, though. What's the? Oh, that's right. We don't want that. That's the combo. If you do it correctly. Damn it! I keep forgetting. After that, you do like 5C, 236A, something like that. You need to work on that. I guess that's off of Fatal only. Normal one. Oops. I should make it so I always have Spark Bolt. Just trying to wait sucks. Wait, did I miss it? Or was it? Oh, electric gauge. Gotcha! I am an idiot. That's right, that one doesn't work because that one's jump cancelable. If you do that one, it works better. So it's better to do that. Interesting, what was I fucking up before? I don't know, it doesn't feel like I was doing anything different, but it comes out that time. What a terrible setup that would actually be. wonder if that would have kept working. Somehow. That's a terrible combo anyway. Oh. He has some really sick jump loops that you can actually do. But I don't know them. I've just seen them in combo videos. They look really cool. Oops. Akumen is one of the characters that this works on. Oops, not that. You can mash out of that. It's very, very fast. But if you know they're going to try to go for that, you can mash out of it. But then you have shit like this. Oops, not that. Where if you do try to mash out of that, you're going to get punched in the face. Or even maybe stuff like that would work. You can actually do 360s, which apparently I can't. Why did I just try to 720? Oh boy. Oh really? You can't even gadget finger off of that? Oh, I guess that doesn't count as being knocked down, so you'd have to go for the entire thing. God, I suck. Can't even remember what I'm trying to do anymore. Oh my god. Of course I get it that time. Why though? Is it because 5A is jump? I mean, I'm not trying to question whether or not 5A is jump cancelable, but I'm wondering. I'm just not getting it because 5A is jump cancelable. Seriously? Like, I'm basically doing full 360s at this point. I'm doing the exact same motion right there that I'm doing right here. But it just refuses to come out. What is... Like, this is actually legitimately confusing. Does it happen if I do... Because, yeah, look at that. You hit A, I'm at forward, down... Down, back, back, up, back, up. That's exactly what gives you this. It's the exact same motion. But yet, for some reason, even though if I did that and I tried to do this, what happens if I do try to spin in the other direction? It gives me sledge every single time. What? What if they're blocking? I'm exposing terrible design right now. Holy shit. There's no reason for that to be happening. This should be a 360 every single time. See how that gave me a 360 immediately? Like, just watch. I'll do the same exact thing every single time. 360 immediately. Doesn't give me a 360. But, like, I know for a fact That's fucking strange. Because I know for a fact I've gotten purple throw. Well, I guess it might have just been a tick throw. I guess it must have just been a tick throw that I tried to go for before. So you literally can't do that setup. You cannot, no matter what, do that immediately into a 360 because of whatever underlying input system Arc System Works has put into this game. You can't, literally cannot cancel. Even though it's special cancelable, you can do it with every single other special move this dude has. It will not work with 360. I mean, obviously that doesn't really work. That is fucking strange. Cause isn't... That is... No, I think he's... Is he recovering or is that canceled? I'm trying to, like, force him. Is this true of everything? So that's actually the issue. Because it looks like you actually cannot 360. They have physically made it impossible. Is that always my issue? Hang on. Is that why I never get 720s? Is because I'm trying to do them too early? Blast jump cancel, that won't work. Now when I just bumped up. That is the problem. That's my problem. I did not know you physically could not cancel. Except for this one, oddly enough. That's why I started to kind of go through his buttons. To see if there was anything else he could cancel. Is there anything that I did not test? We tested 5B. Interesting. Okay. Look at that. We're learning shit. We finally, after what, 20 minutes, we actually learned something? Huh. Fucking magnetism. I didn't want that, you motherfucker. Interesting, what did I start that with? I started that with a counter hit 3C? And it doesn't even let me go that far into a combo? That fucking sucks. What if I do it? Oops, my bad. Goddamn magnetism. Also, even that doesn't work. It's probably the Spark Bolt. Spark Bolt's always actually had surprisingly bad proration overall. There's another thing, too. Like, if you let them get knocked down all the way like that, it actually kind of fucks shit up. For instance. I've always bitched about this, so may as well show it off. If you do... Damn it. If you do that, and then you let them fall, so that was a bit far away. So, unfortunately, I can't really show it off. Actually, I wonder if I set him to block everything, but crouch and don't block switch. Will this counter hit him? Okay, good. 6A will not land there. However... Okay, just don't give me a rapid cancel. Fuck you. If you do it that way, you get normal proration. I don't understand that. I mean, I understand the mechanics behind it. Obviously, if they get knocked down and then you pick them... If they get truly knocked down, which is what counter-hit sledge does, or counter-hit hammer does, it will knock them down for real. And then you pick them back up. Obviously, that hugely prorates what comes after it. But I don't understand why. I don't really get that system. So it's just so strange to me that you can do so much off of it if you do it like that versus if you do this. Then that's the extent of your combo right there. You're not going any further than that. So let me actually check this out. No, okay, so that hammer just, I guess, doesn't have very good... That used to actually be a beautiful starter. Landing with that used to get you so much damage, but apparently they just shit all over it. Which is not a surprise, given that that is all they have done to Tager. That's something I need to practice. I didn't even hit... Yeah, see, you can see it. I'm only hitting that. That's actually something I needed to do. Interesting. So it looks like... Because most of the time when I get hit by that, people only use that version, which doesn't really guard break you for that long. But if you just hold it down for like a half... Not even half a second. Just like a quarter of a second. Nah, a half second. If someone's going to get hit by this, they're going to get hit by that. But look how much longer the actual stun there is. I didn't know that. See, look at that. I'm learning all kinds of things. Nothing about Tager specifically. Oh, excuse me. Well, I guess the 360 thing is pretty Tager specific. I always try to do that a bit too early. Because you got to do it basically when he does kind of like the little grip motion. And I always do it a bit before that. It almost looked like he was going to miss. Like Hawkman was going to go underneath him. Could you imagine, damn it. Could you imagine if Tager could rapid cancel his normal 360? That would be awesome. He honestly should have done that when they nerfed the damage. I mean, I guess, well, no, not really. It was too slow. Yeah, I always do it a bit too early. Stick is so much louder. It's definitely going to take some adjustment, because the stick layout is a bit different, like the, well, it's not, I don't really, I would have to look at it closer, and I can't really do that, because I put the other stick away. It feels like the actual joystick is closer to the buttons in comparison to the layout of the TES Plus, and as well as that, just because the stick itself is kind of bigger. Because it's like, this stick kind of has, it's about the same size as the actual stick part of it. I think it's actually a bit wider. But anyway, like it has kind of like the same basic size as the TES Plus, but then there's just a tiny little thing that's maybe like an inch long, maybe an inch and a half, further off to the right side that features all like the home button, the start button, all that shit, that normally, you know, obviously you wouldn't want to be hitting that accidentally during a match, so it's kind of lower, it's kind of makes it so it's very, very, basically impossible really to accidentally hit that while you're playing. But so because of that, it makes it a little bit bigger, and so the balance is a bit different. So it's going to take some adjustment to get used to this again. It's kind of the same thing as me switching back and forth between, like, keyboards. I don't know how many of you guys have ever tried to, like, maybe you go to school and you use their keyboard, and the layout's just a teensy bit different from your own at home. And so, like, you're just making constant errors all the way through because you're trying to type at your normal speed. But because of the layout, your fingers are just hitting the wrong spots. That happens to me all the fucking time. This is very similar right now. It just, it feels off. But man, I'm so happy this thing supports legacy controllers. I'm not happy at all that apparently my TES Plus didn't even last a year. It didn't even last a year. I just realized that because I ordered it when Street Fighter V came out. That came out, what, at the end of February of 2016? And I got it, I think, like a week after Street Fighter V actually came out, because I had to, it released the same day, but then you had to account for shipping afterwards. So that stick didn't even last a fucking year. No wonder Mad Cats just dive bombed. Do they even still do anything? Are they just a dead company now? Because I know that their whole, like, they even said, our success right now as a company, our existence as a company, essentially hinges on whether or not Rock Band 4 blows up and becomes huge. And it didn't. And so I know, you know, like, obviously they had all the layoffs there, lost a ton of employees. And so I would kind of assume at this point they may very well be just like, they're not producing anything anymore. They're just selling off remaining stock and seeing what happens from there. But I can tell you this, I'm not buying a stick from them again. Not even a year, for a $150, not $150, $190, because I believe it was $189.99. Or was it exactly $200? I think it was exactly $200 for the TES Plus, and then if you wanted the TE2, the second tournament edition, the boring ass one with Ryu on the face of it, that ran you $220. $200, and that shit didn't even last me a year. Fuck that. I'll go Hori. Definitely don't want to go Razor. Because I was actually, oh, that's right, I did record that part. I was looking at the Mad Cats, or not Mad Cats, I was looking at Adar. And then I saw their new stick, which did, I mean, I've seen people using it. It looks very slick. I like the look of it. But then I actually looked at it on the website. That motherfucker is $300. Nah. I'm set. That's the price of an entire gaming system. I'm good. This is very important. In case you're wondering, like, why are you practicing this? What's going on? What's so important about this? This entire combo right here is burst safe. And if you do not understand, like, look at their burst throughout the entirety of this. Even when it's reset, it's still burst safe, apparently. It's crossed out the entire time. They literally cannot. So actually, that was the wrong terminology to use, actually, to call it burst safe. Burst safe combos are when if they burst, the burst still won't hit you. This is literally an unburstable combo. You'll notice that it is X'd out the entire time. And so this is guaranteed damage. And so if you're... That was worrisome. Maybe this stick did fuck up. Because it stopped registering motions for a little bit on me. Just for a short minute. It might have been a little thing, like maybe it's just a little quirk with legacy controllers. But I was holding forward and Tager was not... He wasn't occupied or anything. So he should have walked forward a bit and he just stood there. And then when I tried to do 2-2, it only gave me one downward motion. Yeah. Just have to be on the lookout. But so that's also why, you know, like, hit confirming. Really? There it is. That's why hit confirming into overdrive is actually, can be a very, very important tool beyond, you know, just what everybody uses it for overdrive raid. Number one, obviously, every single character in the game, their max damage... I shouldn't say every single character in the game, like I know it for sure, but if there's any kind of consistency behind the design of this game, which, let's be honest, that's fairly iffy, your max damage is going to be an overdrive hit confirm. You are, if, like, no matter what it is, no matter whether it's a fatal counter combo or regular counter hit, no matter what it is, if you throw an overdrive in there, you should be getting more damage overall. And so that's where your max damage is going to come from, is from an overdrive hit confirm. So it can, for a lot of characters... If you're at half health, maybe even a little bit more, depending on the character, if they hit confirm into an overdrive, you're dead. and you cannot burst throughout that entire thing. So, like, if you have your burst and you're thinking, oh, okay, this is perfectly fine, I would rather save it to potentially use my own overdrive or use it when I'm in a bit more danger, you know, like maybe I'm not in the corner right now or whatever, I got 6k health left, no problem. All of a sudden, they pop into overdrive and you're dead like that. Now you can't burst. It's very, very, very vital to learn when what options your character has to deal appropriately with bursts. Like I said, there's a lot of characters. Hakumen is actually a prime example where he has so many burst-safe combos. I couldn't tell you what they are, but I just know that essentially if you option select your motions in the middle of his combos correctly, like 75% of the combo is burst-safe, and you'll wind up bursting, and he'll just block it, fall back down, and get a full hit confirm, which... you're dead if you're in the... you should be dead if you're in the middle of a combo against Hakumen, provided they have sufficient resources. That's kind of always the little asterisk off to the side when it comes to Hakumen. Provided they have the resources available to them, you should be dead at that point if you give them a free burst. So stuff like that. Or, you know, again, just when you overdrive and now all of a sudden, you know, they can't burst anymore. That's very important. Or, like I said, just... these combos in general. Like, for instance, that is also burst safe. That actually work. Oh, that sucks. Maybe if I let him fall a bit further. That isn't all burst safe, though. Because you have to hit them in between. But... this move in particular, Grand Punish, is in fact unburstable. So that's another option that he has. That's why I was looking at, maybe doing something like that. Oh no, this wouldn't work actually, now that I think about it. Timing. It's so strict. So if I remember correctly, I believe his Grand Punish has like 1400 guaranteed damage. No, that's too high. Maybe like 700. That's what I was thinking about. Yeah, right there. That did what? 727, something like that. But what I want to see... is what happens if I tie them all together. Damn it! That one wasn't real? I would have sworn I did that one good. Did that one well. If I want to use proper English. Really? You see, this is it. The timing is so strict on doing this. That's why I always miss it, is because, like, I know the timing to do it a bit late. And so I just, like, keep fucking it up because I do it a bit too early instead. Fuck. I'm gonna get this eventually. I cannot believe it's already been 40 minutes. You're about to see 40 more minutes of me just not getting this ever. This is actually why I stopped bothering... with Tager's last trial, is because it just wasn't worth it, because this is the ender you're supposed to do. And so it's like going through all of that, which is already fairly spotty to begin with in terms of whether or not you'll get it all to combo correctly. But then you have to end it with this. Which, no matter what you look at with Tager, the single most inconsistent thing he has, I would say, I shouldn't say inconsistent, but the single most strict thing he has execution-wise is this shit. Fuck, and then I fuck up the easy part. God damn it! I mean, I guess I could just use math. I mean, it should be somewhere around 4,400. Oh no, I forgot to account for Gacha Finger, actually. Fuck! But so that did, what, that did like... Because with Gadget, I think without Gadget Finger, that is 36.43, if I'm remembering right, right? So that's 37.43 for Gadget Finger in there. And then, like you say, just the set, again, I don't know what the exact minimum damage possible is. Well, I guess I can just do this. Uh-oh. Ooh, I vastly overestimated the minimum damage of Grand Punish. That only did like 400. So yeah, that might only do about 4.1k. I mean, that's still very, for a completely 100% unburstable combo, that's very respectable. But it also cost you 100 meter. It would actually, now that I think about it... Crashing, no, this won't work. That's probably, I mean, cost you 100 meter, that's probably about the same amount that you would get. Granted, you will get a teensy bit of additional meter back for landing regular hits that you would not get if you just did Magnetech Wheel. I want to tie this all together, goddammit. Gonna waste all that time. There's no closure for you. Gonna blue balls the hell out of you. I did nothing useful. I mean, granted, again, I did learn a bunch of that stuff kind of about the game in general, but I didn't really do anything useful with Tager. Actually, this is the question. I've never really liked any of Valkenhayn's colors. It's very different in terms of, like, once he actually goes wolf form, I like a bunch of them. But in terms of his actual default human form colors, I'm just not a fan. So that's no longer, that used to be a low, right? Now this is his only wolf form low. It's not what I want. How do you do like... It does work though, right? I don't know his actual combos. It's been ages since I've actually tried to play this character. I remember bits and snippets. That's right, I actually forgot he has that now. Forgot about that. Oh, can you not do that? What if I delayed it? No. What if I did? Oops, not that. I keep hitting the wrong button. So wait, does this not hit twice anymore, or is it just because she's airborne? That used to hit twice, didn't it? Or maybe I'm thinking about... I might be thinking about that. No, I feel like that used to hit twice, didn't it? What move am I thinking about? Ah, fuck. So how do you do that wolf break shit? I don't mean that. Even though that is stupidly fast. But how you do like... Because you can do something where you start that, essentially, like, immediately end it. Yeah, that's definitely not it. Because that takes me out of wolf form. But I know there's some way to do it where, like, you basically, you enter the air. That's definitely not it. What other moves does he have? Definitely not it. Maybe it's because I double tapped it. Oh, is that all you? Oh, maybe that's what you do. So you're not actually doing this. You're just jumping and then immediately going down. Oh, I ran out of wolf meter. Maybe that is what you do. I don't know. Can't believe they took that away from me. Wait, I just kind of did it, didn't I? You just... Oh my god, I'm an idiot. You just press down plus D. You don't even do... I thought you had to enter the air first. And then you press down or something, but no, if you just do down plus D, oops, I don't know why I did that. I thought this character was complicated. I know that's a thing too. I should learn this character. Oh god damn it! I keep sitting up and I keep forgetting, so that definitely confirms this thing is wider than the other one. I shouldn't say wider. No, yeah, wider's about right. But so it kind of, it sits further down on my legs and I need to kind of adjust my seating position. I need to start actually, because I kind of... Yeah, I just need to adjust my seating position. I really should learn this character. So that does work. It's an obnoxious amount of recovery to that. Why am I even practicing this when I don't even know? Like, that's probably the better version to go for. I'm playing that correctly, right? Yeah, okay. Problem. I'm not going back to neutral burst. That is somehow fucking it up. Does that not work anymore?
Yeah.
don't know. I feel like that's wrong. I feel like I'm an analyze. I think I'm wrong on the wolf break thing, because I feel like whenever I see people actually do that, the 2C comes out a lot. Well, not the 2C, that's just regular C. It looks like it would be a 2C, but he only has regular buttons. I feel like it comes out a lot faster than that. Maybe that is all they do. And it's just depending on... Because it definitely, yeah. The recovery on this is significantly more than the recovery on that. Well, when Wolf Meter runs out, it doesn't really matter. Was that the max you get? You get 5? Anyway, I've dicked around for long enough. We got a stick to adjust to. Goddamn Mad Cats. Living up to their quality standards. Shit. Alright.